Hi everyone, this is Mike from Okoko, and in this video, we're going to be discussing the three live filters that can be used in Rococo Studio. There's Locomotion 2.0, Locomotion Legacy, and Treadmill. So let's get started. So, when you open up your project, you can go up to the right-hand corner, and you'll find this little wand icon. And these are going to be our three live filters. Now, a general note. In terms of what filter you should record your data in, it doesn't matter. Because if you record your data in Locomotion, and you say, actually, let's try this in Treadmill, you can always reprocess that data in Treadmill. So don't worry about if I record in Locomotion, it's only going to be in Locomotion. Don't worry about it. You're good. You can reprocess it. All right, moving forward. So, as I said, let's talk about Locomotion 2.0 first. This is going to be our default setting. So most of the animation is going to be in Locomotion 2.0. And whenever you switch, I always highly recommend calibrating. So let's do that first. And really, in general, before any recording that you do, you should always calibrate because it zeroes out all of the sensors and it also creates the origin of your animation. All right, so I'm in Locomotion 2.0. And essentially what that does, it allows me to actually translate around the 3D space. Now, we're only tracking what the suit is. How does it know where the 3D space is? Well, guess what? It's my feet. So as long as I have my feet on the ground, at least 1 foot on the ground, the data that we're gonna get is gonna be really good and we can clean it up in our post-processing filters. And the animation that you're gonna get to export out of Rococo is gonna be fantastic to work with. But keep your feet on the ground. Now, yes, you can do some jumps. It does a pretty good job at that. Also, you can do running, you can do walking. There might be, in terms of like the live filter, might be a little difficult, but once it processes it and you use the Locomotion filters and help out with the gizmos and the floor contact, you can get a run cycle in really, really well. So, in general, as I said earlier, most of your animation is gonna be in this. Maybe you can do some fight stuff. Whap! Whap! Ooh, ooh, ooh! Hi-ya! Or maybe you're doing a classic scene. We'll always have Paris. In general, you're always gonna be using Locomotion 2.0. Now, we do have Locomotion Legacy for those who would like to use our first version of Locomotion. So let's switch on over to that. And guess what we're gonna do? We're going to calibrate. Calibrate. Calibration is good. All right, that's all I got. Excellent. So, in general, mostly everything that you're gonna do in Locomotion Legacy, you should just do it in Locomotion 2.0. But there is one thing that Locomotion Legacy does really well, and that's kind of why we kept it in here. And that is hand contact with the ground. So say, hey, Mike, we need to do a handstand, or we need to do a cartwheel, or something like that. It actually does a pretty good job at doing that. Whoa. So, we kept it in there for our users, just in case if you need to do a handstand. Haha. All right, now, I'm going to switch into my favorite filter. Not enough people use this, and I think it's a really powerful tool, so this is honestly why I'm actually making this video, because I want to talk about Treadmill. And guess what I'm going to do? I'm going to calibrate, calibrate, calibration. Sorry. All right, great, so, we are in Treadmill, and essentially what that does is it locks me down to the origin of my scene. So as you can see, I am walking around the room, but my mesh, my skeleton in Rococo Studio is staying right at the origin. So you're like, Mike, why is this important? Well, this is actually really great because if you're just doing, say, just like frame animation and your character isn't moving around, you can just use this. You don't have to worry about drift or weird knee popping or floor contact or anything like that. You can just do the recording in here, which I absolutely love. Also, it's really great for walk cycles. Or maybe you're doing a run cycle. Or maybe you're doing some, you're doing some fight stuff and you need some idles. And then you're gonna do some attacks. So, ooh, one. One, two. One, two, three. Ah. And a lot of times in my demos that I do, or sometimes we'll get feedback from users, or questions that we get a lot is, hey, we need to lay on the ground. We're doing a scene and our two characters are having a picnic on a beautiful green field on a beautiful day. So what should we do? Go to treadmill. I absolutely love this filter because it's locked my character on the root data. So when I go down to the ground, it's great. I'm not gonna drift anywhere. I'm not gonna fall through the ground plane. I can sit on the ground, have a picnic with my scene partner, eat some grapes, drink some wine, have some cheese, and enjoy this beautiful day. All right, well thank you so much for coming and watching this video. I really appreciate it. Please like this video, comment in this video. If you need any help, always, you know, throw a comment in this video if you need help. We always respond to that. Or head over to rococo.com. And of course, you're always always available to email us at support@rococo.com. Thank you so much, everyone. And until next time.